Namaskar. The topic of discussion in this module is on biogeography and outline. The earth is the home for all life. Earth's environmental segments like atmosphere, biosphere, lithosphere and hydrosphere all jointly support the world's population. Geography is the study of location and distribution of living things and the earth's features in which they live. It may be land or water. Geographers also examine where earth features are located, how they came into existence and why their location is important. Geographers search for patterns in the distribution of features over the earth's surface. They seek to discover the reasons for the patterns. Geographers also look for patterns in human economic, political and social activities and to try to find out why these patterns are existing in these places differently. Geography considers four aspects to deal with. They are the location, the spatial relations, regional characteristics and the forces that change the features of the earth. Geography is the scientific study of the locational and spatial variation of both physical, biological and human phenomena on the earth. Geography is a rich and complex discipline involving two key dimensions. One is the spatial dimension and the other one is the ecological dimension. The spatial dimension answers the questions for where things are and why they are. The ecological dimension answers the questions for how humans interact with the environment. The ecological dimension focuses its attention towards the biological resources of the world. One of the branches of geography concentrating this dimension of study is biogeography. Biogeography is the science which deals with the geographic patterns of species distribution and the processes that result in these patterns. Biogeography emerged as a field of study as a result of the work done by Alfred Russel Wallace. The main areas which have stimulated to study this field are the evolution of life, plate tectonics, theory of natural selection and the biological adaptations. Being a multidisciplinary science, biogeography has grown into a bigger field. It is divided into many branches like historical biogeography, phylogeography, zoogeography, island biogeography, paleobiogeography, ecological biogeography and conservation biogeography. Historical biogeography attempts to reconstruct the origin, dispersal and extinction of taxa and biotas. Ecological biogeography attempts to account for present distributions and geographic variations in their physical and biotic environments. Biogeography relies heavily on the subjects like biology, ecology, population biology, evolutionary biology and the earth sciences. In this episode, the following aspects are highlighted: ecological biogeography, historical biogeography, biogeographic patterns, biogeographic realms of the world and conservation biogeography. Let us see the first part of ecological biogeography. Biosphere is the sphere of life. It has its own diversity, distribution and productivity. Human and animals utilize the earth's resources for their survival. Increase in population will definitely require more and more natural resources for food and other commodities. Human activities put more pressure on the existing natural resources. To manage the planet's geographic resources, it is necessary to understand the global distribution of living and non-living things. Biogeography is the study of distribution of biological species with reference to time and space. It aims to analyze where organisms live and with what abundance and why they are preferring only certain geographical zones as their habitat. Biogeography includes the study of the world's biomes and taxonomy. It is an interdisciplinary subject related to geology, biology, soil science, climatology, ecology and evolution. Biological diversity vary over the surface of the earth. Biogeography is the study of the spatial and temporal distributions of organisms. It also seeks to understand the ecological processes that influence the distribution of living organisms over short periods and also to uncover the events over a distant past. These all have resulted in the geographic distributions of these species as we are observing today. In order to do all this, biogeography relies heavily on the information of biology, ecology, population biology, evolution biology, and also the earth sciences. Ecological biogeography analyzes the factors that control the spatial distribution of species existing at present. The most significant environmental factors like temperature, humidity, and salinity are the key elements in the ecological biogeography of many species. Ecological biogeography also attempts to account for the present distributions and geographic variations in their physical and biotic environments. Ecological biogeography deals with the geographic distribution of biotic and abiotic components and the life. It includes the study of the basic principles of ecology and ecosystems and their functions. Ecosystems are the homes for plants and animal life. Humans have created their own ecosystems. Ecosystems have their own functions and components. The functions of ecosystems are controlled by both biotic and abiotic factors. These are called as the limiting factors of the ecosystems. Many limiting factors like climate, topography, and interactions with other organisms play a significant role in controlling the distributions of species. A biome is often referred to as a global scale community of plants and animals and is the largest subdivision of the biosphere. A biome may contain many different kinds of smaller ecosystems. Biomes are typically distinguished on the basis of the characteristics of their vegetation because it makes up the largest portion of the biomass. Biomes are subdivided by the formation class and vegetation units of a dominant species. Plants and animals disperse across the earth and occupy habitats favorable for their survival. A habitat is the specific physical location of an organism, it's where they live. An ecosystem is a functioning entity of all the organisms in a biological system. It is generally in equilibrium with all the inputs and outputs of energy and materials present in a particular environment. It is the basic ecological unit of study. An ecosystem is comprised of habitats, biological communities, and ecotones. A habitat is the specific physical location of an organism, it's where they live. Microhabitats are delineated by climate and subdivided on the basis of their vegetation. Environment is the total set of circumstances surrounding life. A group of organisms and the environment with which they interact is known as an ecosystem. Ecosystem is a self-regulating association of all organic communities and their non-living environment. Interaction of biotic and abiotic factors are the basic processes involved in any ecosystem. Biome is the largest and distinct subdivision of the biosphere. It includes the global scale community of plants and animals. Ecotone is the boundary transition zone between adjoining ecosystems. It may vary in width and represent areas of tension as similar species of plants and animals compete for the resources. Microhabitats are delineated by climate and subdivided on the basis of their vegetation. Microhabitats are smaller in size, such as the habitat along a stream channel or a layer within the canopy of a rainforest. Each species has specific habitat parameters like temperature, moisture, and nutrient availability. Within a habitat, organisms occupy a niche. A niche is the function or occupation of life form within a community. An organism's niche incorporates the physical, chemical, and biological factors that maintains the health and vitality of the organisms. The term biome refers to one of the largest recognizably and distinct ecosystems on earth. the plant and animal communities and associated soils that are characteristic of a given regional climate type determines the biomes. Hence, biogeography involves the study of the following aspects: habitat and types, biomes and classification of biomes, habitat occupation, habitat degradation, ecological niche, microhabitat, and human activities. The abiotic factors vary and control the life on terrestrial and aquatic ecosystems. Hence, all biogeographic patterns are ultimately influenced by the geographic templates. It refers to the distributions and other patterns of geographic variation of the farms and communities across various geographic gradients. It includes climate, soils, aquatic conditions, and microenvironments. The climatic parameters involve the solar energy and temperature regimes, solar radiation and latitude, cooling effect of elevations, and the role of winds and rainfall, the wind patterns and precipitation patterns. Soils are the primary conditions for the growth of plants. So, they control the primary succession, formation of major soil types, unusual soil types, and the plants which are growing above these soil types. The aquatic environments involve the study of stratification of water bodies with reference to temperature, oceanic circulation in the masses of oceans and seas, pressure and salinity variations in the seas and oceans, the tide and intertidal zonal conditions of seas and oceans. The microclimate and microenvironments involve the small scale environmental variations colonizing the microenvironments. Hence, biogeography attempts to study the limiting factors of ecosystems and habitat. The main emphasis is laid on the solar radiation, role of wind, pattern of rainfall, nature of the climate and weather, types of soil conditions, the availability of water, and the aquatic stratifications. Energy flow is a major aspect of biosphere. Hence, biogeography attempts to evaluate the energy capture and use, energy cycles, energy budget, traffic levels, food chains and food web, biomass, and the productivity of the ecosystems. Ecological succession is the development of an ecosystem through a predictable series of communities until a final stable community in balance with regional climate is attained. Hence, ecological succession and their types are studied in biogeography. Let us see the second important aspect of historical biogeography. The science of biogeography was conceptualized by C.D. Buffon has specified that same climatic and environmental conditions were often inhabited by distinct kinds of plants and animals. This became the first principle of biogeography. It is known as the Buffon's law. Charles Darwin's voyage on the HMS Beagle was instrumental in the development of his theory of natural selection and also the origin of species. It was Sclater who gave the scheme of terrestrial geographic regions based on the distribution of passerine birds in the year 1858. It was Alfred Russel Wallace who first wrote about the geographical distribution of animals in the year 1876. The biogeographic principles advocated by Wallace are the following. Distance does not determine the degree of biogeographic affinity between two groups. That is the first one. The second one is climate has a strong effect on the taxonomic similarity between two regions. The next one is knowledge of all distribution of organisms throughout the world is a prerequisite for determining the biogeographic patterns. The next one is fossil records show positive evidences for past migrations of organisms. Paleoclimatic studies are useful in analyzing the extant distributions of patterns. Competition, predation, and other biotic factors play their role in the distribution, dispersal, and extinction of animals and plants over the globe. In the absence of predation and competition, organisms on isolated regions may survive and diversify. Islands, can provide unique patterns for basic understanding of biogeography. When two closely separated species are widely separated in space, they are called as disjunctions. Disjunctions of genera show greater antiquity than those of single species. So, all these aspects have been proposed by Alfred Wallace. Based on that concept of Wallace, the biogeographic principles have been evolved. Four major developments have revitalized the subject of biogeography after the year 1950. They are the theory of plate tectonics, development of new phylogenetic methods, frontier researches in ecological biogeography, and investigations of the mechanisms that limit distributions. The origin of fauna and flora and theories of evolution are the basic aspects considered in historical biogeography. One of the ways of understanding the geographic distribution of species is by studying the evolutionary history of the species. The evolutionary relationships are typically represented as branching tree-like structure called as phylogenetic trees or simply phylogenies. The branching structure of the phylogeny of a set of taxa can be used to differentiate between competing hypotheses concerning the observed geographic distribution of the set of taxa. Speciation, dispersal, the agents and routes of dispersion are all studied in biogeography. Dispersal refers to the transport of propagules beyond the limits of a species distribution area. Colonization is another aspect. The term colonization refers to the establishment of a population in a place formerly occupied or unoccupied by the species. Colonization implies successful reproduction in the new area, not simply the presence of a species there. The other aspects studied are extinction, migration, domestication, and adaptation to environment. In this context, there are some areas which are concentrated in biogeography. They are the gene centers, endemism. Here the word endemic describes a taxon restricted to and native to a particular area. So, endemism is an important aspect studied in biogeography. The endemic areas, the human activities, the cosmopolitanism, the provincialism, disjunction, biotic interchange, divergence and convergence, all these aspects are studied in biogeography. Today, the subject of biogeography has grown with more databases, remote sensing tools, and the geographic information systems. All of them provide more insights to learn about the origin, spread, and diversification of biota with reference to sites, locations, climatic regions, continents and oceans. Let us see the third aspect of biogeographic patterns. Environmental setting has a bearing on the biogeographic patterns. Organisms can be found in almost every part of the earth, but each species has a restricted geographic range in which it encounters a limited range of environmental conditions like latitude, altitude, climates and habitats. Biogeography includes the following aspects: world coordinate systems, geospatial mapping methods, physical setting as the geographic template, plant communities, animal species, human settlements, mapping of ranges, distribution and abundance of species, the range boundaries, the communities and distribution of species and their spatial and temporal changes are studied in biogeography. The species distribution area refers to the geographic range of a taxon. There are so many types of categories existing in this. The allopartic distribution is one. Literally, allopartic means other country. It refers to the distribution areas of different taxa that do not overlap in that place. The next one is the circumboreal. It is found throughout the high altitude forests of the northern hemisphere, and it is available in northern American zones and Eurasian zones. The next one is the circumpolar zone. The circumpolar zone refers to a distribution area that circles either the North Pole or the South Pole. The next one is the cosmopolitan region. The cosmopolitan areas refers to the worldwide distribution of population in urban zones. The disjunct population refers to a fragmented distribution area with two or more geographically separated ranges. The pantropical zone refers to a distribution area that extends through the tropics. The relict zone refers to a distribution area that is mere remnant of a formerly wider range. Distributional similarity, that is called as congruence, between phylogenetically independent taxonomic groups has important biogeographical as well as conservation implications. Two main distributional characteristics are currently used for assessing the cross taxon congruence and surrogacy: species diversity and associated measures such as endemism and rarity and turnover are the important aspects considered in this. Although diversity, rarity and endemism have traditionally been used in most conservation assessments and prioritization initiatives, the focus has increasingly shifted towards community dissimilarity. Let us see the fourth important aspect, the biogeographic realms of the world. Biogeography has had a long history. Biogeography deals with all ecoregions and ecozones. Aerial extension has a bearing on these ecozones. The local sites may be within a few hectares of land. A landscape mosaic may occupy 10 to thousands of square kilometers area. An ecoregion may occupy several thousand square kilometers area. There are two general types of ecoregions identified as terrestrial and aquatic ecoregions. Hence, biogeography attempts to evaluate the ecoregions of the terrestrial and aquatic realms. Ecoregions of the oceans and islands are very important aspects included in the biogeographic studies. The other aspects covered are rapid relocation of species, birds and plants, range expansion of selected species of animals, range expansion of selected species of plants, migratory routes of the animals like birds, dispersal patterns of butterflies, diaspores and seeds, aerial distribution of insects, spiders and mites, biotic dispersal routes. Within a habitat, organisms occupy a niche. A niche is the function occupation of a life form within a community. An organism's niche incorporates the physical, chemical and biological factors that maintains the health and vitality of the organism. They include all biotic factors, abiotic factors, food and other aspects of physiological adaptations. As Campbell in 1996 defines, biomes are the world's major communities classified according to the predominant vegetation and characterized by adaptations of organisms to that particular environment. Six major types of biomes exist in the world. They are the freshwater ecosystems or biomes, marine biomes, desert biomes, forest biomes, grassland biomes, and tundra biomes. The freshwater biomes include ponds, lakes, streams and rivers, and wetlands. The marine biomes include the oceans, corals and estuaries. The desert biomes includes hot and dry, semi-arid, coastal and cold deserts. The forest biomes include tropical forest, temperate forest and boreal forest. Grassland biomes include tropical grassland, temperate grassland and savanna grasslands. The tundra biomes include the Arctic tundra and the alpine tundra. The following are the kinds of realms identified in biogeography: Palearctic realm, Nearctic realm, Neotrophic realm, Indo-Malayan, that is Oriental realm, Australian realm, Afrotropical realm, Sub-Saharan realm and the Oceanian realm. Biogeographical realms are geographical regions out of which particular assemblages of plants and animals got evolved and dispersed. The Nearctic realm possesses a great diversity of biomes, including the tundra, grassland, deciduous and coniferous forests, chaparral and desert biomes. The Nearctic realm has been separated from neotropical by deserts and until recently an absence of a land bridge between them. The Palearctic realm is very similar to the Nearctic realm in terms of the diversity of biomes, including tundra, grassland, deciduous and coniferous forests, chaparral and desert biomes. The neotropical realm is dominated by tropical forests, savannas and the deserts. The afrotropical realm is inhabited by tropical forests, savannas and the deserts. It is separated from Palearctic realm by the Sahara Desert, previously separated by an arm of the sea. The Australian realm has a desert core surrounded by tropical forest and savanna. The Australian realm boasts a unique variety of plants and animals as they have evolved in isolation from outside influence. Poached marsupial mammals like the kangaroo are found in the Australian realms. The Indo-Malayan realm is nearly exclusively tropical forest. It was isolated from the Palearctic realm by the Himalayan mountains. The Indo-Malayan realm was previously separated by a sea lane that has subsequently been closed by the continental drift. The Antarctic realm exhibits a diverse set of ecosystems from temperate forest and grassland in the New Zealand to tundra and ice sheets in Antarctica. Many of the New Zealand's mammals are like those which are frequently visiting Antarctic shores. Finally, the Oceanian realm is dominated by tropical forests. Physical barriers are often the most imposing barriers to diffusion. Impassable topography, large water bodies and unsuitable climates are all impediments for the dispersal of plant and animal species. World biogeographic realms are geographical regions out of which particular assemblages of plants and animals evolved and dispersed. Hence, all these aspects are studied under biogeography. Based on the relative complete compilation of species within well-studied groups, the biogeographers identified 6 different realms with which species tend to be closely related. The world biomes include forest biomes, savanna biomes, grassland biomes, desert biomes, and the tundra biomes. Detailed study of all these biomes are done in biogeography. Let us see the 5th aspect of conservation biogeography. In order to answer the questions about why there are a certain number of species dominate in a particular geographic region, the subject biogeography has incorporated many concepts from community ecology. The number of species existing in a particular place depends on the amount of resources available in that place. It is ultimately derived from the amount of primary productivity. Then it studies the number of ways those resources can be distributed among the species, and lastly, the different kinds of ecological requirements of the species that can colonize the region. So, this is very important in biogeography. The characteristics of these are reflected in the biodiversity. So, biodiversity is the total variation in life, including the number of species, the degree of genetic variation within species, and the different types of ecosystems and the ecosystem functions in a particular region. The aspects covered in this are species diversity, habitat decay and conservation, human induced communities, impact of climate, impact of human activities, impact of industrial development, wildlife corridors, habitat destruction, island biogeography and landscape ecology. Global warming leads to range expansions, dispersal events and new invasions. All living things are closely related to their environment. Any change in one part of an environment, like an increase or decrease of a species of animal or plant, can cause a ripple effect of change in the other parts of the environment. biogeography is entering into a new phase where data on the spatial patterns of abundance and distribution of species of plants and animals are being analyzed with sophisticated mathematical and technological tools today. The geographic information systems and remote sensing technology have provided a way to catalog and map the spatial variations in the biological processes with a striking degree of detail and accuracy. Hence, biogeography has become an important part of physical geography. Let us see some more details about biogeography in the forthcoming modules.